Why, hello there, YouTube, and welcome to a Who Review, another one from me. I am Davros, and I am a Whovian, and today we are reviewing Twice Upon a Time. Yes, the 2017 Christmas special. I thought, you know, I probably best save like Christmas specials for December, but hey, we got plenty to go over in December, so I thought, you know, what the hell, I'll review this one as it is the last episode before we get to series 11. So carrying on from when the series 10 finale ended, when the Doctor was refusing to regenerate, we came face to face with him and the First Doctor, and that, and then next thing, time's freezing because a paradox is being made, because of the Doctor's wanting to change his fate to the First Doctor, and we also have a war captain from World War One that somehow randomly appeared there. And the Doctors have to find, you know, solve the mystery and that, and what's going on and everything. What are these glass robot beings we're seeing? And, you know, how is Bill alive when she died? Well, first of all, this film, it was, not film, this special, well, let's get to my likes and dislikes right away. So, first of all, I liked the story. I did. I liked the story because, for once, it was a Christmas special where there was no evil villain or mastermind at work. It was just simply, you know, two timelines crossing over and time was starting to freeze up, and that because the First Doctor refused to regenerate and so did the Twelfth Doctor. There wasn't a real major villain in this at all. The glass robots turned out to be holograms, memories of people put into robots and stuff, and yeah, I thought that's quite a nice touch, you know, have all your memories scanned and then put into a glass robot so that can live on forever whilst the real you dies, which is sad, and that. Anyway, other likes, I like that this brought back old Rusty. Now, we'd not seen old Rusty since Series 8 in the episode Into the Dalek, where he was like the first Dalek that turned good, and we'd not seen or heard from him ever since, until this Christmas special, I guess with it being Stephen Moffat's last ever episode writing it, I guess he wanted to tie that loose end together. So I like that they brought Rusty back for a brief cameo, and how the Doctor needed to use his data bank to find out what these robots are, and that. So I like that. I also liked Mark Gatiss as the captain. He was, you know, I think in of all the people in history, why him? You know, because he didn't get frozen in time like the rest of the war did in World War One, because that's where he was. He was stuck in the war, and it froze. And I'm thinking, what is with this guy? He's got to be someone important to the Doctor. And at the end, we found out that he was actually the great-grandfather, well, not the great-grandfather, but the grandfather of the Brigadier, because he asks the Doctors if they would mind keeping an eye on his family every now and then. And he told them that his last name was Stuart, and his name was Captain Archibald Hamish Lethbridge Stuart. And I thought, when I heard that for the first time ever, I just like went, I just laughed in delight, because it was just, you know, I was thinking, oh my god, that is why he is the Brigadier's granddad. I was over the moon about that. I just completely thought, oh, that was fantastic. A fantastic touch to that. And now we know why the Doctor became such good friends with him, the Brigadier. And the Doctor still checks in on the family from time to time, even now to this day, with Kate Stewart. Also, I like that they brought Bill back. Stephen Moffat didn't want to bring her back for just a cameo or anything. He wanted her to come back for one last show, and he was right. So I liked Bill in this. She was the same old Bill we knew from series 10. Despite her being a short-lived companion doing one full series, I still like that Stephen Moffat brought her back for one last time. And she was a robot. That was a robot avatar with all the memories. And that, you know, it's like Bill never forgot him. And she wanted to see him one last time, the Doctor. Because she thought he died, but he didn't. And it was her kiss that brought him back, I forgot to mention in the Doctor Falls review. And now for one of my highlights of this episode. David Bradley playing the First Doctor. Now, obviously, it couldn't have been William Hartnell because he's long gone. But William Hartnell did actually make a brief appearance in this, yes. Because the episode started as a previously moment from the 10th Planet. Where we had William Hartnell going, you know, where we had William Hartnell showing clips and that from the 10th Planet, and then it quickly going into Twice Upon a Time, you know, the black and white zoned out and it went into colour and he morphed into David Bradley, but so very little of him changed, and I thought, wow, he really is resembling Hartnell here, and I thought that was amazing how they did that, because we saw it in the trailer. But how they did it, I was just amazed by it. And he was like going, you know, like I did in the 10th Planet review of William Hartnell doing that. Emotions, love, pride, hate, fear. But then as he turns to David Bradley as the First Doctor, he goes, have you no emotions, sir? Yeah, I liked that. I liked how it tied in nicely with the 10th Planet. Because I thought in the trailer where I saw his hand glowing, I thought, oh, is this going to tie in with the 10th Planet? And it did. It did, and I was just blown away by that. I really liked that, how it opened. I also liked, you know, David Bradley, you know, not trying too hard to be like William Hartnell. I mean, he was meant to be William Hartnell's Doctor, but I feel that he brought some of his own creativity into it as well. Not only that, but it did say, you know, Peter Capaldi's 12th Doctor did say, oh, but you're halfway through your regeneration. And I was like, oh, is that why he looks slightly different? But yeah, I also liked how, you know, because at the end of the episode, the First Doctor accepted his destiny and went back to his time. I liked how they brought back the First Doctor's regeneration for the first time in over 5 decades. We got to see the First Doctor's regeneration remastered, still in black and white, but changed into the Second Doctor. And I just applaud at that, because I loved how that tied in, and you know, it was nicely done. And it was brilliant. And that. So yeah, that's one right there. Then of course, Peter Capaldi as the Doctor. For his final episode, he really stole the show for me. And you know, I loved how they referenced all the Doctors between the First and 12th Doctor. And I just love Capaldi. You know, he gave us one last great show, and I thought he was fantastic in this. I like the final speech he made. You know, that speech he was making to the 13th Doctor. And that. And I liked how, you know, he made the decision, and I think he made the right choice, Doctor. And I liked that. I liked how he accepted his fate, and how he was preparing the next Doctor for what was to come. I liked that speech he made. Just that speech, you know, got me excited. And you know, it was like, for once, for the first time since Matt Smith, I didn't feel sad. I did not feel sad for this regeneration. I thought, that's exactly what a regeneration needs to be. It should not be something sad that's going to happen. It should be a bringer of hope, and that's what it was to me. And that, I thought, was a great way for him to send off. And you know, how he willingly let the Doctor go. I like the simple transition it made as well in the end, with the beams and that, and how his face just morphed into Jodie Whittaker. I thought that was great. And when Jodie Whittaker burst onto the screen as the Doctor, when we saw her and she went, oh, brilliant. Her gender to me became completely irrelevant. It really did. I mean, yeah, I thought the Doctor's a woman now, but, you know, the Doctor looked and she seemed pleased and went, oh, brilliant. I was looking and I thought, oh, well, if the Doctor's happy with her new look and that, and I mean, I adjusted quite well to the idea. I mean, if you asked me 10 years ago, I would have been against the idea, but over the years I've had a change of heart, I've grown to the idea, I've warmed up to it. Yeah, I'm all up for that now, a woman doctor, and I'm really looking forward to seeing her in series 11, which is not long now, because the episode ended. I thought I didn't like how it ended. Yeah, that's a dislike. I didn't like how it ended, how she fell out of the TARDIS and the TARDIS was blowing up. I was like thinking, no, because, you know, I figured, damn, now we've got to wait for the next series. But, I'm sure our patience has been greatly rewarded, because from what I've seen, from what we've all seen in the trailers, it looks good. And I'm sure it's going to pay off nicely. So, yes, series 11, bring it on. Back to Twice Upon a Time. Other likes. I liked that, you know. So, one thing I also noticed, it was supposed to be a Christmas special, and the Christmas special before, the return of Dr. Mysterio, whatever, I felt like that wasn't as that wasn't very Christmassy, but I liked it how it was it was a Christmas special, and I liked it when the captain went back to his time zone. And then next thing, it turned out to be Christmas Day 1914, and the doctors got to witness the whole thing unseen, but they got to witness it. And I loved how at the end of the day, the captain looked at the doctors and gave them one salute. I really loved that bit. And the bit, and it, when it turned out to be Christmas Day 1914, I thought, the only day in war history everybody put their guns down for one day and celebrated Christmas. For me, I just got all emotional on that bit, because it was just so nice. And I really liked that bit. So, and also, you know, when the First Doctor went back to his time zone, and when all the soldiers went back to their trenches, it was one final moment with the 12th Doctor. And, you know, I liked how Bill came and how he said, let's have one last look around, and then, you know, Bill's avatar took the shape of Clara Oswald, and we got a brief cameo from Jenna Coldman as Clara, and I like that. I mean, yeah, people have said it's so unnecessary, but I just thought, yeah, you know, because the Doctor forgot about her, and he got to remember her again, and I thought, yeah, okay, and they didn't drag it out too much, and that, so... Was it a necessary cameo? Probably not, but I didn't care about that. But one cameo I did love to death was Nardole. Yes, when Bill and Nardole's avatars, yeah, I thought, oh, Nardole! And he came back, and I thought, yeah, because I didn't like how, you know, how he just ended his time there at the end of the Doctor Falls. I liked how, you know, how he came back for a cameo as his avatar, and he was like going, hello, sir. Yeah, I just loved Nardole in that. I just loved that scene. I got so moved by it. I was like, Nardole! And I had goosebumps, and I'm getting it now just thinking about that and talking about it with you. And they both like said to the Doctor, don't die, but it's your choice. And of course, they talked him round, I guess. I liked it when they all had a group hug, and that was a nice way to send them two off. And then we had the whole send off from the 12th Doctor, the speech he made in the TARDIS at the end. So yes, that is. I think I've given you all my likes. My dislikes on Twice Upon a Time, I don't have any, because to me this was a great episode, a great way for the end of an era for us. And yeah, so final thoughts, I love Twice Upon a Time. So ratings, I'm going to give Twice Upon a Time, this is getting a massive 5 out of 5 for me, because I just love the episode to death. I enjoy the hell out of it, and yeah, that's pretty much it for that. So now we are going to get into the, obviously, you know, hopefully when this review's up, it should be the day before the Series 11 premiere. So, who's looking forward to that? I know I am. So yes, Series 11, I will be reviewing that week by week. Every episode that we see. So, be sure to tune in for that and stuff. So, what about this one? This review, have you seen Twice Upon a Time? You probably have. Let me know down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and hit that notification bell. All of my social media links are linked down below in the description, so be sure to check all that out. And until next time, live your life. I know I've got one, haven't I? Yes.